I have a mission to protect Kihnu culture.
You know, it was always kind of this very magical fairy tale kind of island.
In the Baltic Sea, just off the western coast of Estonia, lies Kihnu. This small island of 700 people is often described as Europe's last matriarchy, where men are traditionally out fishing and the women are left in charge.
And men very often, even nowadays, they are working somewhere else, not in the island. Maybe some men are long-distance sailors or some are builders and they are working somewhere else. What is important in Kihnu culture, that the human life circle leaders are women. So everything what is the initiation rituals is led by women. Wedding ceremony, funeral, this is organized and led by women. So it's very important. And also church tradition is alive and till nowadays important part of our culture, thanks for women. So women have done everything in the land and taken care of the human life and life circle in the land.
In 2008, UNESCO listed Kihnu culture as an intangible cultural heritage of humanity, where Kihnu women were the principal custodians of its traditions.
We are weave in the wintertime our skirts, which are very, very famous part of our folk costume, and also all the mittens and socks and everything. And of course our ancient folk songs and dances, this is most important part. For example, Kihnu wedding songs, which are more than 2,000 years old. This is a miracle that we must do everything to keep this tradition alive.
I am originally from Vancouver, Canada. And I came to the small island of Kihnu, Estonia, because my grandmother was originally from Kihnu and she escaped during the war. And I came here for love.
We are right now at Metsama. It's a cultural farm here in Kihnu, and it's kind of one of the traditional farms, and a lot of the cultural events happen here. And this is where tomorrow, for the food festival, that the evening party will be taking place. And there's going to be lots of dance groups and performers, and there's going to be a band. So it's going to be a lot of fun. So we were just practicing right now. It's really a dance too, which is kind of dedicated to sisters, and the name of the dance is Yhdistynyt, which is, you know, born from one, and it's basically, you know, kind of a love story to my own sisters that I tend to miss a lot, the sisters that I've made here on the island with the dancers, and it's kind of a little ode to women in a way, to how we all connect together.
But the concept of matriarchy is up for debate on the island.
It was quite a culture shock when I first moved here. It was very hard to get used to, and even still, 12 years later, I'm still trying to get used to certain things. I understand that on the outside perspective, Kihnu does look like it's a woman's land and it's the last matriarch in Europe, but I would definitely disagree. I think there are certain families here, yes, that are led by the women, and the women here are insanely strong women. They do everything and they're amazing at what they do. They're hard workers, they can take care of the family, they can work on the field while at the same time they can go do the handicraft and singing and dancing. They do everything. But The male opinion here is what matters the most. If a man says that that's what he wants to do, then that's what is done. And I think that's where a lot of my time, you know, my struggles and my arguments come into play, because I didn't grow up that way.
So what is the role that men have here in the island?
Men bring income, good income. Better income is better. Or you can manage then better. I myself think that Kihnu is very patriarchal society, because we are everybody, all women take care of the men, and men is much more privileged than the women in the family life.
Still, women on Kihnu Island are working hard to keep their tradition alive.
So I do different projects which are helping to protect culture, survive islanders. So it's not only one thing, but it's many things, like language, like folk costumes wearing and traditions, like singing and dancing tradition. Very important is wedding tradition. And it's question in the modern world, how to protect the tradition, how to keep the tradition alive.
Kihnu means to me, it means to me my grandmother. And the way I connected through, you know, through her and with our great aunt and the relatives that we used to visit when we were little kids, you know, it was always kind of this very magical fairy tale kind of island. I would love to preserve the nature here and just the culture in itself. I understand it's difficult because it is in competition with, you know, modern society, but it is something that's so beautiful and precious that it would be lovely to see it to keep going.
The biggest challenge is connected with work. It's so limited, it's so difficult. Nowadays it's very much connected, the work is connected with tourism, but it's very seasonal, it's a short period when the tourists are coming. I'm dreaming also that maybe for the next generation we have enough opportunities to find work, to live here permanently. I know why everybody like Kihnu, and everybody love, and children and young people, and everybody want to spend time here. The main thing is freedom. Here is a freedom.